third, and now the characteristics of the flower in general we have completed, and we have just done that what is a complete flower, what is an incomplete flower, and what are the symmetries of the flower, what is a bract and a petiole. So these kind of the general features we have done, right? जो symmetries में हमने pinomorphic, zygomorphic बनाया, तो ये सारे हमने general features बहुत बन गए हैं. अब हम आ रहे हैं that is on the various whorls of the flower. ठीक है, various whorls, like the whorl of calyx, whorl of corolla, whorl of this androecium and the gynoecium, that is the male and the female reproductive system. So सबसे पहले हमारे पास है the first, that is the whorl from after menstruation, which is usually going. That is the first is the whorl of calyx. So that is the whorl of calyx, that is the structure or the whorl which is called that of the, which is made up of the single units called as sepals. Okay, calyx kya hai? It is a whorl which is made up of the single units called as sepals. Agar aap kisi flower ko view kare and you just involved it like this, and there is a green colored image part or portion just above this petals, colorful petals. तो जो ग्रीन कलर का पार्ट आपको विजिबल होता है, दैट इज अ लीफी स्ट्रक्चर जो विजिबल होता है, दैट इज अ सेपल्स और दैट इज अ कैलिक्स. दैट होल वॉल इज कॉल्ड एज अ कैलिक्स, बट द सिंगल यूनिट ऑफ इट इज कॉल्ड एज सेपल. ओके, सो देयर आर टू कंडीशंस दैट द सेपल्स मे बी फ्री और दे मे बी फ्यूज्ड एज वेल. सो व्हाट इज द टर्म यूज्ड व्हेन द सेपल्स आर फ्री और व्हेन दे आर फ्यूज्ड? दिस इज एनोसेपलस व्हेन दे आर फ्यूज्ड. दिस sepalous term stands for the sepals. Okay, hemosepalous is the term when the sepals are fused. We use the term hemosepalous. I told you, because next when you will be going for the description of these flowers, you are not going to write it in a whole line, in a whole sentence, that the sepals are fused in these flowers. Simply write hemosepalous. That is an answer. It is understood. Okay, then there is polysepalous term which is used for the sepals which are free. If the sepals they are free, they will be polysepalous. Okay, if the sepals they are free, they are called as polysepalous. Okay, fused, you can also write that they are united or they are fused. We are making one single unit, right? So that is hemosepalous or polysepals. The second is the whorl of corolla. In this corolla, there is a structure of the flower that has a special, colorful, and very centered, you can say, structures which are available in the flower that are called as the petals. The single unit that is called as a petal, and the whorl of these petals they are called as a corolla. Okay, that is a one unit that which is made up of these petals. So by these petals, so that is called as corolla. Similar terms are used for the petals, that is if they are free or they are fused. Now here we will be using, for free condition we will be writing polypetalous, not sepals. Okay, for petals it is polypetalous, and when they are fused then it is hemopetalous. The term uses hemopetalous. You can be asked a question simply that what is the term used when the petals are fused, or what is the term used when the petals are free. Okay, so that is the polypetalous or the hemopetalous, or similarly the polysepalous or the hemosepalous terms can be used, right? When we have to describe these flowers, what their whorls, what all things we have to write is, first is their number, second is their color, and the third one is this condition. Okay, especially for describing the flower, we use the three things for the whorl. We will be able to describe the very everything pieces over here. For example, let's say in a flower there are five of the calyx. Okay, so you write calyx. Kya hai five? They are all green in color, so that is green. And lastly, what is it? That is, there are, let's say, polysepalous or hemosepalous or whatever condition. So you write here, it is hemosepalous like that. Okay. Whatever the characters are there, specialized characters specifically should be mentioned along with this, right? Along with these conditions, that is poly and hemo conditions, the three features you have to mention in a flower's whorl. Along with this, there is one more thing that is also to be added, and that is estivation. What is that estivation? Estivation means arrangement of the units in their works. Okay, that is the next topic. It is very, very important, rather. What is estivation or estivation? It is the arrangement of, now write down the next heading, that is estivation. We pronounce it as estivation or estivation. Both is estivation. So estivation, that is the arrangement of single units like sepals and petals in their works. In their works, especially these are estivations are studied from the floral bud. Okay, bud definition is for estivation for cerealias or that. So you write that is it is the arrangement of the single units like petals or sepals in their works in floral bud definition. Okay, that is when there is a flower bud definition. How they are you can say arrangement respect to one another, that is to be called as estivation. So there are different types of the estivations. The first estivation and the simple estivation, that is when a general number of the petals or the sepals in their whorls, that is only 5. Okay, generally in most of the flowers you are taking a pentamerous to write so 5 approximate your number there commonly available to flowers you can have a milia. Okay, that is the 5 sepals are there. Petals may vary, that can be 5 or multiple of 5. That's the pentamerous flowers of the name. Hum dete hain again on the basis of the units. Okay? If the units like say sepals are 3, petals are 9, and somehow the entrance they are 15 or something. Okay? So what is this? This is all the units, they are the multiples of 3. 3 or multiple of 3. Then we call that flower as trimers. TR, trimers. And if it is the 4 or 4's multiple, if it is, then we call it as tetramerous. If it is pentamerous, then it is 5 or 5 multiple. Okay? So like that we use. So it is general number, that is 5. So we are going to study this estimation because of this number only, that is 5. Okay? 5 count ke saath humne isko saari jo types ki estimation ki humne study. So the very first type is here is the velvet estimation. Velvet estimation mein there are all the 5 units. If we draw this circle, and all the 5 units of a whorl, like sepals whorl, that is radius, all the 5 units, they are arranged just in the symmetry, of the symmetry mein banana hai, theek hai? Like let's say this is the axis, central axis, theek hai? So there should be, in the symmetry form, one should be shared on both the sides, 5 hai, so one should be shared on both the sides, this is shared one, okay? Then 2 will be present at the same lens, okay, dono ki jo hai wo same lens pe same unhone symmetry ke wise aapne arrange karna hai. This symmetry is to be maintained, that is the most important thing that you have to keep it in the mind. Okay, symmetry, because now further you will be also making the floral diagrams. Okay, the floral diagrams you banayenge further flower description jahan pe karenge. The floral diagrams mein you will see that there is everything is in symmetry because nature has made it in symmetry. Okay, symmetries we have studied, like ectinomorphic and zygomorphic. Hai na? So ectinomorphic jo organisms hai, 5 units hai, ectinomorphic hai, radially symmetrical, sari taraf se denge, sari taraf provide karega. And hence, this is going to be in all the units also. Okay, units bhi uski symmetrically arranged hoti hai, whorl bhi symmetrically arranged hoti hai. So everything is in a symmetry, right? So you have to follow this, right? Now this is the estivation which says it is a velvet estivation. Okay, velvet estivation. This can be of a calyx or a corolla, both the words. Okay, calyx corolla jab hi aap banayenge apne usme floral diagrams mein jab hi aap banayenge, then we will be distinguishing between the calyx. Calyx ki jo units banayi jati hai wo is tarah se pointed units ke saath show kiya jata hai, aur corolla ki jo units banayi jati hai wo is tarah se rounded structure ke saath show ki jati hai. So we will be using these two types, these two structures, they are in the floral diagrams. Okay, but not here. Till now we are just making a common thing for both calyx as well as corolla. So this is the first find out the estimation, that is valuate estimation. So what is special here in this? This is the valuate estimation here that shows no overlapping. First thing, there is no overlapping. All the ends of the calyx and the torva units, they are present next to one another, and they are not showing any overlapping. So that is valuate estimation. For valuate estimation, you can write the example that of Kellotropis plant. Kellotropis procera, that is Acrotopla. In Greek or in common terms, we call it as Acrotopla. It is a white plant which grows on its own, right? So that is valuate estimation. Clear? Second type of estimation is twisted estimation. Second is twisted estimation. Now, what is this twisted estimation? For twisted estimation, let's say this is a circle. Okay, you know, circle may be useful, you know, I'm making the same diagram after you have another. Or I should also do it. Okay, so I'm making this twisted over there. Okay, talking of confusion. So this is the circle, let's say. Again, in the circular pattern, the units will be arranged. That is the units of calyx and the corolla. This is the symmetry. Symmetrical line, that is the axis along which it has to follow the symmetry. Right? Now for twisted, as the name is twisted, as the name is saying twisted. Twisted means the unit has to overlap its ends. Okay, ends ko iska overlap karna. Let's say ye hamara first unit hai. Theek hai, first unit mein jo iska ek side hai wo thoda andar ki taraf aapne isko banana hai, so that it is like this. Theek hai, ye is tarah se aapne unit banaya and it is bent towards the inner side so that it gets overlapped with the next unit. Theek hai, to sare ek hi direction mein overlapping show karenge is tarah se. Theek hai, ये सेकेंड यूनिट आ गया, इसका ओवरलैपिंग हो गया ना, टच नहीं करना, ओवरलैपिंग है. देन देयर इज अ थर्ड यूनिट, प्रोवाइडेड सिमेट्री नहीं मिलानी है आपने, सिमेट्री सेम रहना चाहिए. सो दिस इज द थर्ड यूनिट डन इन द सेम. इफ यू आर मेकिंग इट इन अ क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन, इट इज इन ऑल इन क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. इफ यू आर मेकिंग इट इन ऑल एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन, सो ऑल शुड रन इन द एंटी क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन. So similarly, this is the last unit. Now this is further overlapped, you know. Sorry, इससे बाहर से आया था. ये बाहर से बना रहे हैं next unit, so ये भी बाहर से बनाएंगे. This is it. This is the fourth unit. 1, 2, 3, 4, and last is the fifth unit. So fifth unit is like this, which is again overlapping, and this is overlapped by. Okay. So this is showing the overlapping. This is all twisted in one direction. So that is twisted estivation is formed. अब इसमें आप सब में देखो, सारे के सारे units में देखो, one is outer, one end of a unit is outer, another end is inner, again outer, inner, again outer, inner. For this it is outer, inner, outer, inner. Why I have written this OI OI? ताकि आपको क्लियर हो कि हर एक के लिए आउट इन आउट इन आउट इन सेम पैटर्न चल रहा है. सो दैट मींस अवर डायग्राम इज परफेक्ट. ओके, सो दिस इज द ट्विस्टेड एस्टिमेशन इन विच वन ऑफ दीज यूनिट्स गेट्स ओवरलैप बाय द नेक्स्ट इनर वॉल. एंड द एग्जांपल्स फॉर दिस यू कैन राइट चाइना रोज. The petals of China rose are very clearly twisted. If you invert that flower, you will see that twist very clearly. Okay. Then there is in the case of the cobra, that is the flowers of this ladyfinger. That is also one example where the twisted condition can be visible very clearly. Right. Now the next is the third one. Any doubts from these two estimations? The third type of estimation is now imbricate estimation. Third is imbricate estimation. For embryo gate, there is the condition that out of 5, the 3 units will be showing the twisted manner and the 2 units, they will be not showing valvic, but 2 will be 1 completely out of 1 and 1 completely in of 1. How is it made? For this, we can say again, let's say this is the arrangement in a whirl with axis of whirl, and then there is a symmetry line. You have to always provide the symmetry line, right? So here are 5 units. 5 units in, 1 puri tarah se hume outer rakhna hai. So that is indicates special feature. 1 puri tarah se outer rahega. Outer means iske dono jo margins hai, jo dono ends hai, ye dono ends jo hai angle, ye dono outer rahenge, overlap nahi karenge. But teen overlapping karenge aise. If this has to be made outer, so ye hamara ek ka element number 1 hai na, this is outer, ye overlapping show karega. Isme dono units andar nahi rakhne, overlap nahi karenge. So next will be again coming from the inner circle. So this is the next one. Clear to? है ना? देखो ये दो units यहाँ पे overlap आ रही, overlap हो गई. ठीक है? Now the next will be coming from again outer side for this. ठीक है? अगर हम इसमें से outer बनाते हैं, तो next हमें overlap करके देना है. वैसे भी कर सकते हैं, नहीं तो हम इसको पूरा inner भी बना सकते हैं. Like this is the inner one, let's say. And this is because I said already I told you if there is one which is going to have both the ends as outer and one which is going to have both the ends as inner. ये देखो ये inner वाला बना दिया मैंने. Again the overlapping is required. So this is 3 units with the overlapped structures. तो ये एक overlapping वाला आ गया, ये overlapping वाला आ गया, और एक finally overlapping. So this is the overlapping which is shown in the 3. Now you can count. There are 3 which are overlapped. This is overlapped, this is overlapped, this one is overlapped. Yeah? Overlapping samajh aa rahi hai na? The margins, they are overlapped. Inner, outer. Inner, outer. Outer, inner. Yeah? So that can mean any kind. But one is completely outer, one second say it. One is completely outer, one is completely inner. Completely inner means dono margin, dono ends uske inner. So this is completely inner, this is completely outer. So that is the estimation, what we call as imbricate. Ye imbricate ki khasiyat hai, imbricate ka apna feature. Estimation. Quintential, that is not in your HERD, so you don't know how to do that. Now there is one another which is a kind of estimation. It is a special type of an estimation, and that is we call it as Dexy-Levy estimation. It is seen in the, especially in the case of the floral whorl. मतलब कि petals का जो whorl है, flower के petals का जो whorl है, corolla. In the corolla of the pea plant, ठीक है? So that is the estimation, it is Dexy-Levy estimation, and it is a special feature of the pea plant. Peas corolla, the pea ke corolla ka ye special feature. Now what is this Dexy-Levy? Dexy-Levy estimation that shows zygomorphic symmetry. Showing zygomorphic symmetry means now this will not be rounded, this will be oval. ठीक है, zygomorphic कराया था ना आपको, that is only in one plane it shows symmetry. So this is to be made symmetrical to one plane. That is why I have made it oval, not circular. Right? Then there is line of symmetry also. Line of symmetry ये बीच में. Here the whorl of the corolla, this is the whorl of the corolla, that is the petals in the pea plant, that shows a special feature as the flower is having one big आउटर मोस्ट पेटल, एक सबसे बड़ा उसके पास एक ऐसा आउटर मोस्ट पेटल है जो पूरे फ्लावर को कवर करता है. इफ यू हैव सीन दैट और आई विल आल्सो शो यू दिस टाइप ऑफ द फ्लावर, दैट इज अ पी फ्लावर. सो दिस इज हैविंग द आउटर मोस्ट दैट व्हिच इज गोइंग टू कवर द इनर वॉल्स ऑफ द फ्लावर. ओके, सो सिमेट्रिकल बनाना है आपने. दिस इज लाइक इसका लेंथ जो है वो सिमेट्रिकल शो करना है फ्रॉम बोथ द साइड्स, राइट? क्लियर? Then the next is the two whorls, sorry, the two petals. Okay, एक ही whorl में पांच petals हैं. एक outermost सबसे बड़ा हो गया. ठीक है. अब इसके बाद जो next को आते हैं, they are showing the overlapping type of the arrangement of the petals like this. Okay, the two are showing the overlapping. That is, one margin will be towards the inner side and one will be towards the outer side. So if this is the inner cycle of overlapping area. तो नेक्स्ट विल बी शोइंग द आउटर सर्कल दैट इज अब अगले जो दो पेटल्स हैं वो यहां पे इनके भी बीच में से होते हुए आ रहे हैं गॉट इट सो दिस इज द फ्लावर और कैलिक्स सॉरी कोरोला कोरोला ऑफ द पी फ्लावर ठीक है एंड व्हेन वी राइट इट्स कोरोला कोरोला जब लिखते हैं इसके कोरोला का तो वी राइट इट लाइक 2+2+1 बट हियर द इनर टू आर फ्यूज्ड फार्मूला में ये सिंपल होता है फ्यूज्ड का जब आप ब्रैकेट लगा देते हैं एक नंबर के साथ ठीक है बाहर वाला फर्स्ट फ्री फिर दो जो नेक्स्ट हैं वो भी फ्री फिर अंदर वाले जो सबसे अंदर वाले दो हैं वो फ्यूज्ड है तो फ्यूज्ड कैसे शो करते हैं यहां पे आप सिंपल दो यूनिट्स को जॉइन कर रहे हैं यू कैन शो इट बाय दिस ट्रायंगल ओके you are joining the two open units you can show it with this semicircle things okay or for this you can even show it by this coil theek hai yahan pe petals bhi ab isme coil kitna bhi show kar sakte hain so this is the petals of the whorl that is corolla whorl that of the pea plant theek hai so you can write an example here p but that also only and only leaves corolla whorl that shows the maxillary estivation okay now these petals they are also given the special name they are given the special name what is that name the outermost two are called as the standard and the middle two are called as the wings And the innermost two are called as keel. जो joint हैं, जो fused हैं, उनको बोलते हैं keel. ठीक है? So this is all about the estivation and the two of its non-essential whorls description. Further, we will be proceeding to the androecium and diadochium and their conditions. Right? Anybody having any doubt, any question?